Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is a video I've been waiting to do for a very, very long time. One of my all-time guitar heroes. This is a Jack White gear guide. Whether you love him or you hate him, I'm guessing if you're watching this video, you are a fan. He's not going anywhere. And he changed the game. He made it cool to be in a two-piece band. He made it cool for the garage rock scene to not be shy about being a bit rough around the edges. I was hitting this Telecaster so hard in the intro there that it was gone out of tune. And you can get away with that when you're playing White Stripe stuff, because it's all about emotion. For an absolute Raji, Jack is a very dynamic player. He is very aware of his rig, how hard to hit it to get certain tones, how light to hit it to get other tones, and it's quite a simple rig, but it's very peculiar in certain ways. And in this video, I'll be talking you through the timeline, basically, starting from 1999, the self-titled album. It kind of, the tone pretty much stays the same throughout, but starting with Screwdriver and like Jimmy the Exploder, all the way through to the solo stuff, so Lazaretto, Blunderbuss, touching on some Dead Weather stuff, as well as some Raconteurs, and everything in between. So the big elephant in the room, no pun intended, is the fact that I haven't got an airline guitar. Two reasons. First reason, everyone who does Jack White sound like videos uses these crazy airline guitars. They're very pawn shop 60s Sears kind of guitars. So I thought I'd talk about it a bit, because it's basically just a single coil. It is resoglass, and I'll touch on the specs in a second. But he loved Telecasters when he did his solo stuff. Now he's got a plethora of beautiful guitars, which again, I'll talk about shortly. Second reason, the new ones don't really cut it. They obviously do, and I had someone who was willing to lend their new Eastwood Airline, which looks exactly the same as Jack White's, the Jack White spec one. But they're made from wood now, mahogany. Whereas the original ones, Jack's was a JB Hutto, a 60s one from like a Sears, like Argos essentially, like a cheap Argos guitar. His was a resoglass, so it was made from fiberglass. It was totally hollow. It looked like humbuckers, but it was actually single coils in the shape of humbuckers, and like it was hollow, it was plastic, it was a plastic cheap guitar. And the modern ones look the same, but they don't really sound the same, and that's why I didn't want to harp on about that too much, and that's why I'm not using one. So instead, for the majority of this video, I'll be using this beautiful Telecaster. Jack, when he started doing his solo stuff, straight away from everything White Stripes, the spearmint red and white was gone, and this lovely bluish hue was bestowed upon him. He didn't really change his tone much because, well, he did a little bit, because he went from having to fill so much space with Jack and Meg being a two-piece to now having an entire band behind him with a dude with a mustache on a pedal steel, that chick with a violin. So there was less space to fill, so he kind of slimmed down his rig a little bit, but he totally changed what he was playing. He started playing a Highway 1 Telecaster in Daphne Blue. They don't make those anymore. Everyone's like, oh, is it a fancy custom shop one? No, it's just a Highway 1 that's been modified slightly. So this is a Daphne Blue Fender Vintera 50s Modern. It's a vintage spec Telecaster with some modern appointments, and it's in Daphne Blue, and that's why I'm playing it. As long as you've got something with single coils, that you're pretty much there. Quick little rundown on what he's done to modify his Highway 1. I don't know if I can put a picture on the screen, but just Google it. Powder white, so he's powder coated all the metal, so it's white. There's a B50 vibrato. There's a filter Tron from a Gretsch in the neck. There's a Gretsch-style armrest here. That's also powder-coated white. The tuning pegs are powder-coated white, and that's pretty much it. As far as I'm aware, it's the original Highway 1 pickup in the bridge, because he does use lace sensors and stuff and get some custom stuff made, but I do believe it's the original Highway 1 single coil in the bridge of his Telecaster. That's enough of that. So the Telecaster was the main guitar on Blunderbuss and Lazaretto. I'll chat about Boarding House Reach more in a second. And this is the guitar you use when you want to get all the cool... kind of fun stuff. I'm going to explain all this in a second, so but first we're going to talk about the guitars. So this was the guy, well, the blue Telecaster. Any Telecaster with a single coil will be the guitar to get you that Lazaretto blunderbuss tone. Gretsch also plays a huge part in Jack's tone, whether it be the Raconteurs, his own solo stuff, like in the video for Lazaretto, he's actually playing his triple jet, which I'll talk about more shortly. Even White Stripes days. He did have his JB Hutto Airline, but if you watch Under Great Northern Lights, he just play a Gretsch on a few songs, and he loves a good Gretsch acoustic. But I'm not going to be doing any acoustic stuff in this video because he plays really expensive vintage Gibsons. But yeah, this is a Gretsch 5232T in Tahiti red with the cream binding. I think it looks kind of White Stripesy, like pepperminty. It's cool. And this is the Lazaretto guitar. I don't know if you recorded on it, but it looks cool on the video. More bite than that single coil on the Telecaster. Quick thing, Jack's playing a lot of upstrokes. He's very aggressive and there's a lot of he plays really weird. A lot of kind of upstrokes and he attacks the guitar. So you might knock your guitar out of tune, but that's totally fine because you're playing Jack White stuff. You'll find most of Jack's Gretsches in the Raconteur stuff. When he's got his triple jet, which is essentially one of these, but a fancy one modified with three pickups. There's the copper top, which is exactly the same, but the top has been dipped in copper. There's the one with a microphone in the back. So you pull the microphone out and it goes through the amplifier, through all the pickups and stuff. He's like bypass the pickups and it turns on this green bullet microphone by Shure. It does a lot. So yeah, it's that kind of Raconteur's tone as well. Good sustain on this. It's only 450 quid or something like that. Everything I'm using today, besides some things I'll talk about shortly, will be linked in the description box down below. You'll also find a lot of the Gretsch used in The Dead Weather. A lot of that stuff live when he plays guitar, he plays his Gretsches, but we all know he likes to dabble on a drum kit. This, ladies and gentlemen, is an EVH Wolfgang. Now, recent fans of Mr. White will know that he loves a good Wolfgang. He loves a good EVH Wolfgang, and the reason why is really cool. Huge Van Halen fan. No, it's actually because, like I was saying, he played really crappy stuff, deliberately. Like, he liked fighting with stuff. He didn't want to have to spend a lot of money on guitars. He worked with what he had. Well, worked in the pubs and clubs back in the day, worked at Wembley Stadium and the White Stripes, and he can kind of continue that ethos in his self-titled stuff, obviously his solo stuff. He had some fancy guitars, but it was kind of like, I haven't got to go and try too hard. Everything was recorded to tape. Everything was done analog, just the way Jack's lived his life. However, he got sick of that. He got sick of it. And for Bordenhouse Reach, everything was digital. There's synths in it. There's everything's like plugins and stuff, which is really cool. He basically just said he's tired of being hard on himself. So he Googled, what's the easiest guitar in the world to play? And it's an EVH Wolfgang. Eddie Van Halen designed this guitar in the mid-2000s after his little stint with Peavey to be the easiest guitar in the world to play. And after Googling it, Gretsch is with Fender, as is EVH. So he spoke to his maras at Gretsch and Fender and said, can you sort me out with some Van Halen guitars? And he got them sent. They're really cool and they're custom. So this primer gray one is I thought was very Jack White-ish. He's got a blue one, he's got the stealth one. They've all got blue pickups though. The Floyd Rose has been anodized blue. There's big blue inlays on the neck. But most importantly, he plays lace sensor pickups in them. These are Wolfgang pickups, so these are a lot hotter than what Jack uses, but the style and the feel and the look is definitely there. So the majority of the time these days, he plays his lovely Wolfgangs and all of their beautiful variants. I forgot to mention they've got the Gretsch thing on as well, the Gretsch arm guard. So, so cool to see on an EVH guitar. He also favors other guitars. He really enjoys the Skunk Baxter Firebird, which he plays for a few songs during the set, which is a very innovative Firebird with little switches and stuff. It's kind of like a modern-ish Gibson, like phase switching and stuff. And also the Ernie Ball St. Vincent signature guitar, because he loves the fact that St. Vincent designed that to work for the female form and stuff. She wanted a very comfortable guitar because she didn't enjoy playing big guitars, so she thought that fit perfectly with a female kind of thing, and he thought that was awesome. I think it's awesome, and the St. Vincent guitars are great, and Jack plays one live a lot of the time. He's also got a massive gold Flying V, but he doesn't really play that much. The one guitar he does play still from back in the day is a guitar that I'm going to touch on right at the end of this, and it's a song that everyone probably wants to hear, but I'm not going to play it right till the end. I'm going to play it with this Gretsch, but that can wait till later. So that's all the guitars and why he plays them. Let's talk about my signal chain. Let's start by mentioning just the amplifier. This is a Fender Deluxe Reverb. He is a long-time Fender user and loves a good, big, clean Fender amp because it's a great platform to mess with. He hasn't got like massive rigs and stuff. He's not the Edge from U2, but he does rely a lot on pedals to get more out of the amp, and it's got to be a good pedal platform amplifier. You can get great solid-state amplifiers these days, like Boss Katanas take pedals really well, but I'm in a guitar shop and I could use this, so I'm using this. First thing I'm going into is a Whammy DX. And there should be a picture of that on the screen right now. And I'm using the DX because it's what Jack uses. I used to use an original Whammy back in the day to go up an octave or up two octaves. When he's playing his Raj solos, again, all up-picked. Then back to the riff. And he also used a POG, a regular POG, as well as other things to get that octave down for that song that I'm going to play in a bit. Whereas the DX is all that built into one. So there's the Whammy and there's also the drop tune, so you can go from standard, the down a whole octave. I'm going to play the riff at the end. I'm going to save it till the end. From that, I'm going into a POG 2, which I've got set up right now for the Blue Orchid tone. Right, anyways, distorted tone. You can get that tone with a regular POG, like I was saying, but that's the setting for Blue Orchid. There's some really cool hidden overtones happening, at least live anyways. On the record, it might be a bit different. Moving along from that, MXR micro amp. He's always used one of these, and it's simply just a boost. It either boosts the clean amp to make it louder, he boosts an overdrive to shift it into some more the next level of saturation, or he just makes everything go crazy by turning everything on at once. With the clean sound, actually, not with a clean sound, because it'll destroy Alex's ears down there. Let me just... That's all that's doing right there. Into this. Now, this is mine. And a lot of people think that you have to get the stuff Jack White makes and creates to get his tones. Alex, I'm a big fan. This is an octave generator fuzz, gated fuzz thing. And it's crackers. Again, clean sound. That sounds awesome. There's no controls on it, so it's either on or off. That's all you can do. But it's not magic. It's not like you're capturing lightning in a bottle. Jack managed to get this tone before he made his own pedal, simply by using a big muff and a noise gate. and pogs and stuff. So if you turn the pog on, a noise gate, and a big muff to get that gated fuzz sound, it's essentially all of this. It's cheaper than that as well in one single pedal, but I just wanted to use it in this video to show you what it sounds like. I think he used it on his vocals for I'm Shaking as well. See, it's not the pedal. It's not like a magic pedal or something. The big muff, what we're going to use next, is much more of a magic pedal. And that's just the big muff. Everything's set at kind of like 1 o'clock-ish. Now, the final pedal is a pedal I'm using instead of an amplifier. This is the JHS Twin 12. And again, this is mine. This is an older variant. You can buy a newer variant. If it's not available at PMT in the description box, just give us a call or call your local store. Say you've watched the Jack White video that Dagan put up and we can get this pedal for you from JHS. It's essentially a replica of one of his favorite amplifiers, which you can't buy anymore because it's very old, very cheap, and a lot of them are very broken. Exactly the same as his Airline, the Red Airline guitar. Sears Silvertone Twin 12. And this is a Twin 12, it's an amp in a box and it delivers this tone. It's got a weird kind of sag to it, but it kind of, it's bright and it sounds a bit garage rock and a bit broken. It's also very reactive to how you play it, exactly like Jack. Hit hard, it distorts. Hit a light and it stays clean. Great when you push it with a microamp. Kind of garage rock tone. Now again, this is a very cool pedal. You can get very close with a Tube Screamer and an EQ pedal. That's what I used to do before I got this. Tube Screamers poke, boost the mids, use the EQ pedal to scoop some of the mids to kind of fight them against sonically each other, and you do get very similar to that kind of saggy low end, but then it blossoms into a beautiful high tone. That's the wrong key. As well, as a bit of a test, I have one of the new Electro-Harmonix ripped speaker fuzz overdrive things. Everything's at noon. This is going to the Fender clean amp. It's the most kind of garage rock pedal out there. It's got a bit of gate to it as well. Kind of attack, it's got the dynamics, and again it's going into a clean amp. He does use the Fender a lot to make it distort and to make it growl, but you just gotta turn them up really loud. So if you have space to turn up a Fender Twin or a Fender Deluxe Reverb, or any of the other little daft crazy amps he uses, like the Silver Tones. Actually, I'm going to use my platform online right now, sorry PMT, to ask anyone if they are selling in the UK a Sears Silver Tone Twin 12. Please let me know, because I want to buy one very, very badly. So hit me up on Instagram, Dagan Wilkin, and I'll buy you Twin 12 for me. Then do another video using it instead of this. Right, I've wasted long enough. Now it's time to talk about one of the greatest guitar riffs ever invented. It's played on one guitar. It's an old K solo, old K hollow body guitar, which has been covered in paper. So it's had lots of paper stuck to it many, many years ago, and it looks absolutely haufen. But it's just that tone. It uses it for one song in the set. It's always at the back. And as soon as he picks it up, everyone knows what they're gonna play. So without further ado, here we go. Seven Nation Army. So, like I said, played on that beautiful old K guitar. And again, this was a guitar that was cheap. It was a cheap catalog guitar that you bought your begin. It was a beginner guitar, essentially. A super old, crappy guitar that was really hard to play. But that's what he recorded it on, and he's played it at every single show ever since. And you can't find them anywhere because they all broke. Same as the amps and the original ones. So the closest I could get was this beautiful Gretsch Streamliner. Totally hollow. And the big tailpiece, because Jack's K has this big tailpiece. This has a humbucker in though. I will say the K only has a neck pickup. So there's no bridge pickup. It might sound better on the bridge pickup, but I'm trying to be authentic. There's only a neck pickup, so I'm using this in the neck pickup on this. The guitar is tuned to open A. Playing it like this without the amp on, it's like a country guy. So E A, C sharp, E. So you can kind of play. Jackie uses a slide, he uses a chrome slide, but I suck at playing slide, so I'm using a glass slide because it's a bit easier. For the chorus, turning on the micro amp to boost your amplifier, your distortion pedal, or in this case the Twin 12, dropping it down one octave with the DT, the drop tune, which is built in to the whammy. You can buy them separately, but again, that's what Jack uses. And I think, ladies and gentlemen, that is the Jack White gear guide. Want to add anything, please comment down below, because I like learning about this stuff just as much as you guys, and I'm a massive guitar nerd and a massive Jack White nerd. I've seen him concert five times, got all the merch, got all the gear, bought all the gear, and you don't need it. It's not lightning in a bottle. You can craft this tone by yourself with other pedals. Everyone's ear is different, everyone's amp setup is different. Don't rely on the original stuff to get the tone, because now he's got the plasma coil, the Game Changer Audio, there's separate pedals, like a piano style pedals with whammies built in. You never used these back in the day, and you got the tone, so you haven't got to rely on this. But if you want to, you can. I'm not going to sell it, so you can buy your own if you want. And that's it. Let me know your favorite Jack White song, how much you love this video, and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for more lovely guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on anything that I spoke about besides these two, you can drop us a message on Instagram if you want to know about these guys, or sell me your silver tone. Get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk by clicking the links in the description box down below. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan. And I'll see you next time.